एवरीवन, वेलकम टू बृहन मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन वर्चुअल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर एंड आई एम मिसेस स्नेहल कोडांबे, योर इंग्लिश टीचर फ्रॉम VTC. लेट्स बिगिन विथ टुडेज सेशन.
हाय एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टुडेज सेशन. माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, सी ऑल ऑफ अस हैव मेनी स्वीट मेमोरीज विद अवर चाइल्डहुड or our childhood days, right? Whenever we meet our childhood friend, we start talking about our past days, how nicely we enjoyed them, what we did, how we played, what mischievous we were when we were small. So in this way we chat with our friends whenever we will meet. Or sometimes when your siblings or your cousins, you all sit together and then you talk about your past days, and whenever you remember all these days, you just wish that we should have those days back. बघा, आपण एकत्र जेव्हा जमतो, भावंड असोत किंवा आपले कझिन्स जेव्हा आपल्याकडे येतात किंवा लहानपणीचे सवंगडी मित्र मैत्रिणी आपल्याला भेटतात. आता तुम्ही 9th स्टँडर्ड मध्ये आहात, तुम्ही आता नेक्स्ट इयर 10th मध्ये जाल. शाळा संपल्यानंतर काही वर्षांनी जेव्हा आपले मित्र मैत्रिणी आपल्याला भेटतात, तेव्हा आपण शाळेत असताना काय गमती जमती केल्या याबद्दल आपण बोलतो. काही वेळेला आपण आपलं राहतं घर सोडून दुसऱ्या घरी दुसऱ्या ठिकाणी राहायला जातो, आणि मग पुन्हा आपण जेव्हा काही वर्षांनी त्या ठिकाणी जातो जिथे आपण लहानाचे मोठे झालेलो असतो, तिथे गेल्यानंतर आपल्याला आपल्या लहानपणीचा सगळा तो काळ आठवतो आणि असं वाटतं की पुन्हा जर मला ते दिवस मिळाले तर अशाच. With this theme, there is a poem in our book, and we are going to read that poem, and we are going to see, we are going to experience the same thing what we have discussed just now through this poem to a butterfly. So let's see what is poet of this poem has to tell us. So, to a butterfly, this poem is written by William Wordsworth, a very famous poet, William Wordsworth. To a butterfly. So, this poem is addressed to a butterfly. Read about William Wordsworth, the poet of this poem, born in 1770 and passed away in 1850. He was a British poet and he was born on April 7, 1770 in Cockermouth, Cumberland in the Lake District. He continued his studies at Cambridge University, a very world famous university, Cambridge University. He made his debut as a writer in 1787. See, you can see at early age he has started writing. Okay, in 1770, when he was just 17 years old, when he published a sonnet in the European magazine. At the age of 17, his sonnet, a poem, was published in the European magazine. So this is about William Wordsworth. We will read about his household or about his family. William was the second of five children. After his mother's death in 1778, he was sent to Hawkshead Grammar School. This is where his love for poetry was first established. 5 years later, his father died. Now, why am I telling you all about his family is that you can understand. See, at very early age, he has lost his parents and he was studied in a boarding school, and that's why he has some of the memories about his family, about his siblings, and whenever he goes there, then he gets emotional and then he writes this poem. Okay, so this is about the Wordsworth household or about his family background. So this is the poem. We'll read it first and they will go stanza-wise. To a Butterfly by William Wordsworth. Stay near me, do not take thy flight. A little longer, stay in sight. Much converse do I find in thee, historian of my infancy. Float near me, do not yet depart, dead times revive in thee. Thou bringest gay creature as thou art, a solemn image to my heart, my father's family. O pleasant, pleasant were the days, the time when in our childish place, my sister Emmeline and I together chased the butterfly. A very hunter did I rush upon the prey with leaps and springs. I followed on from brake to bush, but she, God love her, feared to brush the dust from off its wings. So here you can see poet is addressing to the butterfly, and through this poem he is remembering his childhood days, how lovely those days which he has spent with his sister. So after reading this poem, you can see the central idea of this poem is that how childhood flies away like the butterfly. It tells us how a childhood is very important and how that person must make well out of it and enjoy every moment of their childhood. आपल्याला ह्या पोएमची सेंट्रल आयडिया किंवा थीम हीच आहे. तुम्हाला कळलं असेल ही कविता वाचल्यानंतर की आपण म्हणतो मराठीमध्ये की बालपणीचा काळ सुखाचा, लहानपणीचे दिवस हे एखाद्या फुलपाखरासारखे उडून जातात आणि खूप सुंदर ते दिवस असतात. कुठल्याही प्रकारचा ताण नसतो, कुठल्याही जबाबदाऱ्या नसतात, फुलपाखरासारखं स्वच्छंदी आपलं लाईफ असतं आणि म्हणून ते दिवस जे असतात ते आपण एक एक क्षण त्याचा जगून घ्यावा. सो दिस इज द थीम ऑर द सेंट्रल आयडिया ऑफ दिस पॉइंट. Read this poem and you will learn this poem. Stay near me, do not take thy flight. A little longer, stay in sight. What that poet is telling to the butterfly, he is addressing to the butterfly. Now you can see he is grown up man now and he has visited his native place, and when he goes there to roam around, and then when he look at the butterfly, he addresses it and he says it, stay near me, do not take thy flight, a little longer stay in sight. Oh butterfly, stay near me, you be with me, do not take thy flight, do not go away from me, a little longer stay inside, you stay in front of me. So here poet says that but to the butterfly, do not go away from me, you just stay near me. Why he is requesting him, you will come to know gradually. A little longer stay inside. So here are some of the new words. Thy means your. Okay, do not go away, you do not take your flight, you do not fly away. A little longer. Much converse do I find in thee, historian of my infancy. Whenever he looks at that butterfly, he remembers all his childhood days. Much converse do I find in thee. तो जेव्हा त्या बटरफ्लायला बघतो तेव्हा त्याला त्याचा भूतकाळ आठवतो, त्याचे बालपणीचे दिवस आठवतात. मच कन्वर्स डू आय फाइंड इन दी. जेव्हा जेव्हा मी तुझ्याकडे बघतो मला तुझ्याशी खूप बोलायचं असतं. मी माझ्या लहानपणी काय काय केलंय त्या इतिहासाचा तू साक्षीदार आहेस. माझ्या बालपणीचा काळाचा तू साक्षीदार आहेस. तुला पाहिल्यानंतर मला माझा इतिहास आठवतो, मला माझा भूतकाळ आठवतो. मच कन्वर्स डू आय फाइंड इन दी. दी मीन्स यू. हिस्टोरियन ऑफ माय इन्फन्सी. इन्फन्सी लहानपणीचा बालपणीचा काळ. तू माझा भूतकाळ किंवा माझ्या इतिहासाच्या काळातला एक साक्षीदार आहेस. जेव्हा जेव्हा मी तुला पाहतो तेव्हा तेव्हा मला माझ्या लहानपणीचा तो अतिशय सुखाचा असा काळ आठवतो. What poet tells or requests to the butterfly? We will see that. Float near me, do not yet depart, dead times revive in thee. Thou bringest gay creature as thou art. So you can see here some of the words which are not usually read or written by us. So that is from the Latin English. Okay. Float near me, do not yet depart. Depart means do not go away from me. Float near me, माझ्या जवळपास तू उडत राहा, तरंगत राहा, माझ्यापासून दूर जाऊ नको. Dead times revive in thee, माझा जो भूतकाळ आहे तो तुझ्या भोवती बांधला गेलाय, गुंफला गेलाय. Thee means you. Thou bringest gay creature as thou art. So we will see meaning of this word. Thee means you. Thou means you or you. Bringest is the bring. So in this way, he has used this word. And art means are. So float near me, do not yet depart. जरा थांब ना माझ्या बरोबर, माझ्या भोवती भोवती तू जरा फिर ना, तरंगत राहा ना. पण तुझ्या भोवती माझा भूतकाळ विणला गेला. जेव्हा मी तुला बघतो, मला खूप सुखद असा माझा बालपणीचा काळ आठवतो. तू जेव्हा माझ्या बरोबर किंवा माझ्या भोवती असा फिरत राहतोस, तेव्हा माझ्या त्या बालपणीच्या सुखद सुंदर आठवणी अशा मला आठवतात. आणि त्या मला आठवायचे आहेत, त्यांच्यात मला रमायचंय. जितका सुंदर तू आहेस, तितक्याच सुंदर माझ्या लहानपणीच्या आठवणी आहेत. Thou bringest gay creature as thou art. तुला पाहून किंवा तू माझा बालपणीचा किंवा माझा भूतकाळ माझ्या समोर घेऊन आलेला आहेस. A solemn image to my heart, my father's family. Whenever I look at you, I remember the solemn image to my heart, my father's family. Now see how he has mentioned here my father's family. He has not mentioned here as my family. My father's family means his family with his siblings. You can see here in this picture, his mother is there, his father is there, and all other siblings are there. You can see there were five children. And you can see the author or the poet of this poem with his siblings. So a solemn image to my heart, my father's family. माझ्या हृदयाच्या तळाशी जपलेलं असं एक सुंदर चित्र, एक असं पवित्र सुंदर चित्र जे तुला पाहून पुन्हा एकदा ते आता माझ्या डोळ्यासमोर येतंय. माझ्या कुटुंबाचं चित्र, माझ्या कुटुंबाचं जे दृश्य आहे ते आता माझ्या डोळ्यासमोर येत आहे. माझं लहानपणीचं घर, यू कॅन सी हिज होम इयर. आणि माझी फॅमिली, माझं कुटुंब, हे सगळं मला आता पुन्हा तू नव्याने त्यांची आठवण करून इकडे दिलेली आहेस. अ सॉल्मन इमेज टू माय हार्ट, माय फादर्स फॅमिली. ओ प्लेझंट प्लेझंट वेअर द डेज, द टाइम वेन इन आर चाइल्डिश प्लेस. दोज डेज वेअर व्हेरी प्लेझंट डेज, व्हेरी ब्युटिफुल डेज. When we used to play, the time when in our childish plays, those days were very beautiful days. Because you know, in childhood we are just playing. We are not thinking about our studies, our responsibilities, our family, who will scold us, nothing. So we are just enjoying our days in the childhood, right? So oh, pleasant, pleasant were the days. Those days were very beautiful. The time when in our childish plays. What they were playing? My sister Emeline and I together chased the butterfly. Which game were they playing? Chasing the butterfly. And he was not alone playing that game, but with his sister Emeline, togetherly they were chasing the butterfly. You can see here. My sister Emeline and I together chased the butterfly. A very hunter did I rush upon the prey with leaps and springs. I followed on front, break to bush. What was I doing? A very hunter did I rush upon the prey with leaps and springs. I followed on from break to bush. I was running after you. I was butterfly hunter and I was rushing after you. You were my prey. And how was I rushing with leaps and springs? I was jumping upon after you and I followed on from break to bush. Where did I follow you? From break to bush means a place overgrown with bushes. He remembered all these things. की मी बटरफ्लाय पकडायला कसा धावायचो एखाद्या शिकाऱ्यासारखा आणि उड्या मारत जीव गवतामधून झाडांमधून झुडपांमधून असा काय मी तुम्हाला पकडायला पळायचो की आता तुम्हाला पाहिल्यानंतर ते सगळं मला आठवतं. अ वेरी हंटर डीड आय रश अपॉन द प्रे विथ लिप्स अँड स्प्रिंग आय फॉलोड ऑन फ्रॉम ब्रेक टू बुश. At the end of this poem, what the poet says, but she, God love her, feared to brush the dust from off its wings. Although the poet and his sister Emmeline, they were going for the hunting of butterflies, but he was running as a hunter behind the butterflies, but the Emmeline feared to brush the dust from off its wing. Though the butterfly was near to her hand, they were near to catch, but she never tried it. She was so soft-hearted girl. Oh God, please love her because she never hurted you. She never troubled you. She always feared to brush the dust from off its wings. Means ती इतकी soft-heartedly इतकी हळव्या हृदयाची मुलगी होती की जरी तुम्ही तिच्या हाताशी असला तरी तिने कधीही तुम्हाला पकडण्याचा प्रयत्न केला नाही. And whenever the poet looks at that butterfly or whenever he sees the butterfly, he remembered all the childhood days, those sweet, sweet, pleasant days, how those days were lovely days with his siblings. So now you can see here the poet has visited his native place and whenever he looks at that butterfly and he remembered, he gathered all the sweet memories from his childhood and he addresses the butterfly, do not go away, I still want to be in that past. पोएट इकडे त्या बटरफ्लायला सांगतोय की बटरफ्लाय प्लीज उडून जाऊ नको माझ्या अवतीभोवती तू तरंगत राहा कारण जोपर्यंत तू माझ्या भोवती आहेस तोपर्यंत त्या रम्य भूतकाळात मी रमणार आहे. मला माझे ते भूतकाळातले लहानपणीचे स्वीट डेज त्या गोड आठवणी मला आठवायच्या. सो दिस वॉज द पॉइंट. Appreciation of this poem. We will begin with the title. The title of the poem is To a Butterfly. It is written by our author. The author of this poem is the poet William Wordsworth. What is the rhyme scheme? The first stanza is AA, BB, CB, CCB. And the second stanza is AA, BB, CA, CCA. You can check it with the stanzas from the book. My favorite line is, my sister Emmeline and I together chased the butterfly. A wary hunter did I rush upon the prey with leaps and springs. He remembers that. Now he is grown up. Now he is asking to butterfly to flutter around him. But when he was a child, he used to chase the butterfly like a hunter. Your favorite lines may be different than this. You can write your own favorite line. The next point, theme or central idea, as I told you in the beginning, the speaker of the poem looks back to his childhood days and the sight of a butterfly reminds him of the beautiful childhood days he spent with his sister chasing butterflies in the countryside. So this is the theme or the central idea. The figure of speech is inversion. We are going to learn in detail about it. Special feature of the poem is this poem is a lyric. Here the poet remembers his childhood days with great affection. The sight of a butterfly reminds him of the beautiful childhood days he spent with his sister chasing butterflies on the countryside. And why I like the poem? I like this poem for its simplicity and the imagination. So this was the appreciation of the poem. Now we will move to the activities of this poem. Pick out from the first stanza four expressions where the poet pleads with the butterfly not to go away. Pleads means he requests here. So we will write four stanzas here from the first stanza, four lines or four expressions. First is, stay near me, do not take thy flight. पहिल्या स्ट्रांझा मधले असे चार एक्सप्रेशन्स आपल्याला इथे लिहायचे आहेत की ज्याच्यातून पोएट बटरफ्लायला रिक्वेस्ट करतो. स्टे नियर मी डू नॉट दाय फ्लाइट. मच कन्वर्स डू आय फाइंड इन दी. अ लिटिल लॉन्गर स्टे इन साइट अँड फ्लोट नियर मी डू नॉट यट डिपार्ट. सो दीज आर द फोर एक्सप्रेशन्स वेअर द पोएट प्लीड्स विथ द बटरफ्लाय नॉट टू गो अवे. Say who reminds the poet of his childhood. We will read one by one and then we will write the answers. Very easy answer. Who is afraid to touch the butterfly? You know the answer is in last stanza. Next, who is like a hunter? Very obvious answer. And who is the poet's sister? Very simple question. Take your answer. Who reminds the poet of his childhood? The butterfly. Who is afraid to touch the butterfly? Emmeline. Who is like a hunter? The poet himself. And who is the poet's sister? Emmeline. Okay. While doing the appreciation, we have seen that there is a figure of speech inversion. Let's talk about it. Let's see what is the inversion. The figure of speech in this poem is inversion. What is an inversion? Sometimes the normal word order, it changes in the lines of a poem to emphasize something or to make the line sound better. This change in word order is called inversion. What is an inversion? Sometimes a normal word order is changed in the lines of poem to emphasize something or to make the line sound better. Next, there is an activity. Can you find examples of inversion in this poem? So this is an activity from this poem. We will try to do this. Write them down, then rewrite the lines using regular word order and compare the effect. बघा आता ह्याचा किती सुंदर ऍक्टिव्हिटी आहे ही. आपल्याला ह्या पोएम मधून आपण काही असे इन्व्हर्शनचे एक्झाम्पल शोधूया. वी विल राईट देम डाऊन अँड देन वी विल रीराईट द लाईन्स युझिंग द रेग्युलर वर्ड ऑर्डर अँड देन वी विल कम्पेअर हाऊ डज इट साऊंड. बघा, अ लिटिल लॉंगर स्टे इन साईट. सो दिस इज example of inversion from our poem. Stay in sight a little longer. Baga kasa vatta aikun. A little longer stay in sight. Stay in sight a little longer. Effect baga lages badallela aplya lakshat yeto. We'll take next example. Much converse do I find in thee. I find much converse in thee. So you can see in first line, the line from the poem, you can get the poetic touch with those framing of sentence. Okay. So this is called the inversion. Much converse do I find in thee. And in regular order, I find much converse in thee. It does not have that poetic touch. Next, pleasant were the days. The days were very pleasant. So you can see in such type of construction we read in prose passages, right? But in while writing or reading the poem, you should have that rhythm. So for creating that rhythm, The writer uses different types of figures of speech in the poems. Pleasant were the days. The days were very pleasant. Next example from the poem. My sister Emeline and I together chase the butterfly. So here see the rhyming. My sister Emeline and I chase the butterfly together. See, you can find out the difference. Next activity. Note the words rush, bush, brush. Their spellings look similar. Whenever at a glance, if you look at the words, you can find out the similarity in their spelling. But the pronunciation of the words is different. Okay, pronunciation is different. Rush, bush, brush. It is known as I rhyme. काय म्हणायचं याला अशा टाईपच्या जे असतात एक्सरसाइज त्याला आय राईम असं म्हटलं जातं. आता ऍक्टिव्हिटी काय आहे बघा. फाइंड एक्झाम्पल्स ऑफ आय राईम्स अँड ट्रू राईम्स फ्रॉम द अदर सोर्सेस. आय राईम्स अँड ट्रू राईम्स. ओके, आय राईम्स म्हणजे आपल्याला स्पेलिंग जरी त्याचं सिमिलर दिसत असलं तरी त्याचं प्रोनाऊन्सिएशन डिफरंट असतं. Activity of I rhyme with some of the examples. Comb. Look at the pronunciation of next word. Womb. See the similarity in spelling. Comb. Womb. Read. Dead. Almost same hai baga spelling. But pronunciation vega hai. Read. Dead. Wind. Bind, wind, bind, and but, put. आपण नेहमी वापरणारे हे शब्द आहेत. सो सच टाइप ऑफ वर्ड्स आर कॉल्ड आय राईम. ओके, सो नाव यू कॅन फाइंड आउट सच टाइप ऑफ अदर एक्झाम्पल्स फ्रॉम युअर बुक अँड राईट इट. सो यू वॉच दिस व्हिडिओ, यू लर्न मोर अबाउट विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ अँड हिज पोएम्स अँड you enjoy this poem and do the rest of the activities. Okay,
that's all for today. So you will revise whatever we have learned in today's session. Please subscribe the channel and press the notification button to get the link of next video. Bye bye.